didn't have an intro, now I've got one. It's your boy TJ London, and I'm back with another video for the Afro Sheen Gang. Let's roll the intro.
Please subscribe. Please. Please.
God, you call me by my name. The love you give me, I just can't deny.
Yeah.
No longer blinded, I can see you. I'm on my way to meet you.
We gotta talk.
How is everybody doing? I hope you guys are all doing well. Me, I am doing great because I have a week of work, so I am chilling for this whole week. And that you guys can obviously tell that because I'm working, I cannot post regular videos. So this is what I'm going to try and do this week. Anyway, from the title, I don't know what I'm going to title this video. I never know what I'll title these videos at the beginning. I just want to talk about something very important, right? I did make a video about this on TikTok, but I just sat here and realized I need to actually make a longer video on it because I feel like a lot of Christians are fake. Let's be honest about it. A lot of Christians are fake. And let's talk about why a lot of Christians are fake, okay? And I know I'm just diving right into it, but I don't like wasting time or else I forget what I'm going to say. The reason why I'm saying a lot of Christians are fake is because Jesus was the only man that walked earth that was perfect, right? But we have to remember that because we are human beings, we cannot be perfect. Why can't we be perfect? That's simply because we sin every day, 24/7. Sometimes we sin without even realizing. And why did Jesus die? Because he died for our sins, right? He sacrificed his life for us, which is why we are here today, right? And I feel like we need to remember that. But we also need to remember that when we give our lives to God, when we become saved, when we become baptized, the minute we make that declaration and make that decision, the devil is not happy with that. Why? Because you're leaving that life behind where he had control over you, but now you want to give God that full control and give your life to God. The devil don't like that. Right? And I feel like a lot of Christians nowadays, they will come on TikTok, because TikTok is the place where you'll see a lot of Christianity and lots of Christian content and this, that and the other, sometimes on Instagram as well. But you'll see a lot of people glamorizing a lot of things, like making worship look good, putting some background music in, recording themselves praying, doing this, doing that. Now, let me just say this. I'm not saying come on here and document your struggles. I'm not saying come online, come on social media and document each and every single part that's going in your life, that's making things turn upside down. I'm not saying come out here and blabber your personal business. No. Keep that stuff to yourself. But what I'm saying is there are so much Christians out there that would rather glamorize things than actually let you guys know, like, not all that glitters is gold. And I don't want you guys to hear this and think, wow, so being a Christian isn't that good after all. No, it's the best decision that you could ever make. Now, don't let that confuse you, because it is the best decision you can make. But remember what I said a while ago. When you commit your life to Christ and you say that you want to serve him, the devil is going to come at you 10 times harder. Well, let me rephrase that, 1,000 times harder than he would at the average person. Well, why is he coming to you so much harder than he would to the average person? Let's think about that. Because in the world, the average person does not serve Christ, okay? So because they don't serve Christ, they're just in the world and the devil already has his eyes locked on them and is basically controlling them. Because they don't care about God or want to hear about the word of God. So the devil already has them wrapped around his arms. And that sounds crazy, but it's the truth. Look at all these artists. Look at all these musicians today. Look at all these celebrities. Look at all these influencers. Look at all these TV commercials. Look at all these things around you going on. It says enough, right? The devil is all over the place. Which is why as Christians we don't belong here anyway. But let me just say something. The reason why he's coming at you harder, the reason why the devil's coming at you harder is because he wants you back. He wants you back in the world. And that's why when a lot of Christians give their life to God, and the minute they get baptized or whatever, or get saved, some people, when something hits them, they immediately just like, right, do you know what, burn this. I'm going to go back to what I was doing. This is too serious for me. How am I supposed to pray 24/7? How am I supposed to do this? Why am I going to do all of this just to get the enemy off my back? Some people actually think like that. And this is why I said a lot of Christians are fake. Because a lot of these newer Christians who've just given their life to God see these things on TikTok. Because 90% of the time, the average person is on TikTok nowadays, right? So some people that just get baptized and just give their life to God, they immediately go on TikTok. And when they see all of this Christian content, they're like, wow, like, I wish I could have these Christian friends. I wish I could have this relationship or marriage where we're just focusing on God. This looks so amazing. I wish this could be me. I wish that could be me. You know, and so much people get that planted in their mind, and then they just make it their mindset to focus on having that one thing that they're seeing online rather than focusing on their relationship with God in order to get that thing that they are seeing online. Replay that if you didn't get it. But that is vital. So much times as Christians, we want the blessing, but we do not want to work for it. Now you may hear that and be like, why should I have to work for something that I'm getting blessed for? Our God is not a genie. He's not just going to grant you with this and grant you with that without nothing. If you're not focusing on God, if you're not reading your Bible, if you're not even worshipping Him, why should He bless you? Why should He grant you all of these things? If you're focused on this particular job that you are working more than you are focused on God, why should He come and help you? Why should He bless you with this, that, and the third? If you're focused on social media and your presence and your looks more than you're focused with God and your relationship with God, why should you receive blessings? And because a lot of Christians don't think like that, bad things happen to them, or things happen to them that makes them a bit weary or fearful. They just run away from their faith because they're just focused on that pictured mindset that they see online where everything is so nice, people getting their blessings. I wish this could be me, wish that could be me. But you don't want to work for it. But as Christians, we have to work for it. You know, you will hear certain people say, oh, in my valley experience, in my valley season, everyone will go through a valley season. But some people go through a valley season without even realizing it, and they just turn away from their faith completely. But I'm here to tell you guys today, that does not have to be you. Because through all of this stuff that you may go through, whether it be family issues, whether it be your friend not talking to you, whether it be someone giving you a hard time every time you go to this certain place, work, school, wherever it be, it does not have to be like that for you. But through those times, you will get your breakthrough. You will get your blessing. But how do you get that blessing? How do you get that breakthrough? You've got to keep knocking. I was in church the other day, and one of these guest preachers came over and said that, you know what? To get a breakthrough, it's like knocking on a door. And you keep knocking. And the more you knock, your knuckles start to hurt you. Your arms start to hurt you. But you want that breakthrough, right? So you keep knocking till that door will break. At this point, some people would stop knocking. But you've got to keep going till that door officially breaks. And that is how you go through struggles. That is how you go through problems that you're facing. You keep fighting to get that breakthrough. Now, don't get me wrong. In the Bible, it says that the battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. So that means God should be fighting the battle for you. But when it comes to you getting your breakthrough and you dealing with that one person at work, all that knocking is you ignoring that person. All that knocking is you trying to block out that person. All that knocking is not responding to the way certain people are talking to you. All of that is just you trying to get through the, that is you working. But if you retaliate in the wrong way, you react in the wrong way, you pop off in the wrong way, that prevents you from getting that blessing. Do you see what I'm trying to say now? But I just want you to know that as a Christian, these things will always happen to us. Because as I said a while ago, the devil is on our back 24/7 because we are serving Christ. And there's this meme that's going around saying, never back down, never what? But literally, never back down. Never back down. Because how are you supposed to get to that blessing? You know, everything that you go through, it's going to be a testimony for somebody. That's why you have to keep fighting. Because your testimony, what you're going through, when you get through it and you explain it to somebody else, they may be going through a lot worse and you go and tell them what you've been through. That may break them through what, that may get them out of what they're going through. And it's only God. It's only God. And I want you to remember that tonight. Or whenever you're watching this. God will help you. God will be there for you. But don't be deceived by social media. Don't be a fake Christian. To a point where you hide all the things you're going through because you want to look good on social media. No. But anyway, with that being said, I hope you guys were able to get something from this. And regardless of who is watching, I hope this message got out to you today. And I just pray that you will get through what you're going through if you're going through something. And even if things are hard for you, you will get that breakthrough. I just want to leave that with you. In Jesus' name. And if you're not subscribed, hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you see more videos like this, and I will catch you guys in the next video. God bless you all. Stay safe, and in a bit.
Please subscribe. Please. Please.